Hello students, a warm welcome to Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Myself, Nagavini Dadamani, a lecturer. I have completed my BE M.Tech from B.V. Bhumareddy College of Engineering and Technology, Hubli. Currently, I am working as a lecturer in Government Polytechnics for Women, Hubli. Let us see the concept where this branch has come into existence. So today, we are living in the age of information and technology. This information age is also known as computer age or digital age. It's a historical period that began in the mid-20th century. The digital age, it refers to the time period in which personal computers, new technologies were introduced to provide an ability for the users to easily and rapidly transfer information. So what it is trying to say is the information needs to be transferred easily and fast. So that means the basic concept behind this existence of this particular branch is the broadcasting of information and the communication between two users. So for that, the electronic devices were introduced, designed, so that there can be a better communication and there can be a better advancement in this communication. So now we will see the applications of electronic engineering or communication engineering. We shall see a few of the examples now. In that, the first one is cell phones. 90% of our population, we are using cell phones. We cannot live without cell phones. We cannot survive, in fact, without cell phones. Cell phones are used for everything. Maybe it is like for online classes, office work, or it could be maybe a map, for so many purposes. So now what we are seeing here is, every day we see that there is a lot of technological advancement taking place. Now cell phones have changed from simple to smart. It is upgrading every now and then. A new technology is introduced, a memory, a speed and performance is what is getting changed every now and then. Whether it is a pandemic or whether it is a recession, there is no stop in advancement in technology. We are seeing that it is getting upgraded, right? So now we shall see the first ever portable mobile phone was this, that is Motorola. As we see the evolution of mobile phones, we see that from this Motorola, today we are using the smartphone, where there is a change from a simple mobile phone to a smartphone here, which we call it as a touchscreen now. Yes. Now we will see there are changes even with respect to speed, performances, right, the size and all. So if you see the size here, sorry, speed here, the first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, we can see that there is so much changes in the speed here. That is, first generation was 2.4 kilobits per second. Imagine the speed then, and now imagine the speed, it is 1 lakh kilobit per second. So we are in the era of fourth generation and going to the fifth generation, okay? And if you see the performances, when it was the first generation, it was normal voice call. That is what we used to, because it was there only for the communication. So having a call with the next user was very important. So it was basically a voice based. But then coming to second generation, there was a texting messages you got introduced. Coming to third generations, we have got access to internet. Now fourth generation, most of our work is done in a mobile phone, right? It could be video, multimedia, texting, internet access, everything, right? Now also we can see that the sizes of the SIM, that is, it has gone from mini, micro and to nano SIM cards, right? So there is so much changes, upgradation is happened in the technology here. That is, whatever the electronic components which are there, which are present inside this mobile, whatever is there, it is like it is showing the advancement. The devices are also getting upgraded. There is a changes in the devices what has been used inside. Now we shall see here, that is, the first mobile phone, it has an antenna of this length, and now the in between we had a mobile phone which has antenna which is shorter than the first one, but now we are seeing no antennas here. The antenna is already built inside the mobile phone, it is not visible, right? So to this level we are seeing that there is electronic devices have been modified, changed as per the technological requirement. Now let us see the next some of the in short, if we have to speak, what we are observing is the world has shrunk small with the advance in technology, where electronics and communication plays a major role and we are easily able to communicate with the people around us. So that is what we have come to a conclusion here, right? So the world has the life of a human has made easy with respect to communication because the electronics and communication is playing a very major role. Now let us take a tour on further applications of electronics and communications. Okay, recently we had seen that past 2 years COVID has hit tremendously on human life. We had so many disastrous event happened in the past year. So what we are seeing here is medical health of a people needs to be improvised, right? So even the electronics and communication, it plays a role in medical field also, a major role in medical field. So it could be like a very important electronic devices nowadays. What we are using is in this pandemic are oximeters, BP machines, digital thermometers, and still more to go. So now you can see that these oximeters, digital thermometers, BP meters, they all have a digital reading, right? So the digital reading is what it is. The electronic devices have been introduced inside those equipments where there is a conversion from analog signal to a digital signal, right? And also these, like if you see the oximeters, they are using the sensors inside, that is electronic devices inside, where we can they can measure the oxygen level in our body. So now what these things are like, that non-invasive. Non-invasive means if we before, if the same thing, that is oxygen saturation needs to be measured, they have to use a needle or they have to prick in the body. So that now the electronics have brought such a changes here, that is such a modifications where most of the devices are non-invasive. They are not invasive. You need not prick into the body. Okay. So because of the sensors which have been used in these equipments, so we have one subject what is called as a medical electronics, which we will be where I'll be explaining about the subjects. I will take that. So medical electronics is what? It is a study of electronic instruments and devices used for diagnosing and curing the health. So what does electronics and engineers have to do with this? It is a design of embedded system applied to medicine and biology. That is, whatever the electronic devices of the designing, what we are doing is, that is what has been applied to this medicine and biology here. Now coming to the next, that is a space and technology. A satellite is a word which everyone are aware of. So when a satellite is launched into the space or in on moon, or onto any other planet, the satellite has to bear the harsh climate whatever it is entering into, right? So what is the responsible of an electronics engineer here? So we are like electronics engineers know that designing circuits for aerospace application is more complicated than doing so for normal standard electronics. So now the PCB designers, they design systems for the harsh environment for outer space while minimizing the project failures and also the cost. So now you can see there are some examples here, the where my arrow is showing here. These are the components, like so might be solar panels or the antenna, whatever has been used here, they are all are the designs of electronic, okay, equipments. And here you can see that there is a rover which is moving on this. It has to, they have to make sure what when there is a design is done, it has to make sure that it is not a flat surface. The surface won't be flat. It has to it has to move on to the not flat surface. So, and also you can see this image where this image is the PCB design, where you can see the images here, the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, where it is rolled into a rover here, that is a roller, where inside it consists of this particular PCB design. So that means PCB is also, that is a printed circuit board, is also a subject what we are having in our diploma, where we will be learning like very basics of PCB we will be learning. I'll just explain that also in the next upcoming sessions. So even the design, this PCB design helps, like it makes things flexible here, because we cannot have a rigid body or a rigid any surface, right? It has to be flexible to move on to any kind of surfaces. So that kind of design also needs to be considered into our mind. And also we have to make sure whatever has been designed, it will have a minimum failure, right? And also the cost needs to be considered. So for all these things, obviously the electronic engineers have to design the circuits for aerospace applications. So now we are seeing here communication engineering, which includes the mode of communication such as radio, internet, satellites and broadband, and also wireless telephone services. So this is an where my arrow is pointing. This is an example of a parabolic reflector or a parabolic antenna of a Doordarshan, and this one here is a parabolic antenna of a satellite, that is a satellite earth station, where it would be receiving the signals from the outer space. And here are the types of antennas which are used in a telecommunications. Depending on the need and the performance, the design of these antennas would vary. So there is a subject also on this, that is a digital and analog communication, where you would be learning how this antenna wave propagation takes place, how the signals are transmitted and how the signals are received. So all these details will be explained in the upcoming sessions. And now another examples would be like in aerospace, that is it could be in aeroplanes, where how the look. See, another example is of aerospace electronic design, which involves you can see that cockpit of a pilot, where most of the devices, whatever the navigation, everything you are seeing is made of electronic engineering. And here you can see that one more very fine example is the industry is getting automated. That is happened because of the power electronics techniques. So in power electronics, what is it? It is like the control of energy is what takes place. Like for example, now I have a fan in my home, so there is a regulator. I try to change the speed of the fan. So I'm trying to regulate the speed of the fan, right? So I'm trying to control the power here, control the energy. So that is just an example in a home. But to tell you frankly, when it comes to industry with the very higher industries, the large scale industries, the automation is very important there. So when we call it as automation, we see that there is a electronic devices or electronic design is inculcated in that automated industries. For example, you can see that there is a crane here. It has to lift heavy objects. So to use that to lift heavy objects or to perform that work, there are so many navigations are there here, which all are made of electronic design. And also now coming to here, there is a bottle which is getting filled, right? So now the there are mechanical parts which are used here. The bottles would be moving and it would keep getting filled and it would get packed. But the electronics part, what it comes into picture here is, it has to make sure, that is, there is a sensor has to be placed, or there has to be signal which needs to be sent, that the bottle has when the water or when the juice or a beverages, whatever, gets filled, it has to know that okay, it has filled to this level. So now it has to stop and it has to fill the other bottle, right? So all that technology or all that aspect would be would come under electronics engineers. So we are the one who give a design for such aspects here. So now these are some of the higher end applications is what I have explained here. So just wanted to give a brief introduction about electronics engineers. So that is the reason I just went with the higher end applications. But to tell you frankly, if you just see the small applications, go to your home and you can see that you are using the remote controller. Obviously, it is made up of electronics, and you are using the stereo. It is made up of electronics. Nowadays, everyone are using a washing machine where there is a digital display. Inside, there is a PCB board, right? So it could be a refrigeration, or it could be a car which is automated. That is also having the electronic equipments inside, right? Besides mechanical parts, it has got electronic equipments. So now electronics is used in every aspect of our life. I can say that it is an evergreen subject which is never going to stop bringing the new technologies into the world. It would keep upgrading, it would keep innovating. So that is what I want to say, that there is a new innovation takes place every now and then. So I would say that you have entered into a branch where you are a part of a new innovation, new creation.